Korean Daily Words, Day 3. Hello, this is Korean Buddy, Sora. Today, I will introduce 10 words and example sentences. Korean sentences should be conjugated to sound natural. So I'll choose a conjugation format each time and making example sentences using it. This way will help you understand the example sentences better. Alright, so today's conjugation format is 를 거예요. This is the form that you can use for the future tense. But also you can use it to express your supposition based on a personal experience that like things that you have seen or heard. So you are pretty sure that your supposition to be true. But here, today, I will use 를 거예요 as a just future tense. And I have another videos about 를 거예요, but that video is more focused about how to express your supposition. So, but at least after watching that video, you guys can learn how to conjugate using 를 거예요. So, if you are wonder how to make it, please check out the video. Alright, then let's check out today's daily words. Number one, 덥다. 덥다 means to be hot. Example, 내일은 더울 거예요. 내일은 더울 거예요. Tomorrow will be hot. Tomorrow will be hot. So here, 내일, tomorrow. 은 is topic particle. 더울 거예요 mean will be hot. 내일은 더울 거예요. Tomorrow will be hot. Number two, 춥다. 춥다 means to be cold. Example, 이번 겨울은 추울 거예요. 이번 is this. 겨울 is winter. 은 topic particle 추울 거예요 means will be cold. So 이번 겨울은 추울 거예요 means this winter will be cold. Number three, 시원하다. 시원하다. 시원하다 means to be cool. Example, 내일 날씨가 시원할 거예요. 내일 날씨가 시원할 거예요. 내일, here, 내일 means tomorrow. 날씨 is weather. 시원할 거예요 means will be cool. So, 내일 날씨가 시원할 거예요 means tomorrow weather will be cool. Number four, 소개하다. 소개하다 means to introduce. Example, 내일 저는 여자친구를 부모님에게 소개할 거예요. 내일 is tomorrow. 저는 is I in a polite way. 여자친구 is my girlfriend. 를 is object particle. 부모님 is my parents. My parents here. 에게 is to. And 소개할 거예요 means will introduce. So, 내일 저는 여자친구를 부모님에게 소개할 거예요 means I will introduce my girlfriend to my parents tomorrow. Number five, 좋아하다. 좋아하다 means to like. Example, 그는 그 선물을 좋아할 거예요. 그는 그 선물을 좋아할 거예요. Right? 그 is he, topic particle. 그 is 더 here. There are two good, but it has a totally different meaning. And 선물 is present, 을 is object particle, 좋아할 거예요 means will like. So, 그는 그 선물을 좋아할 거예요 means he will like the present. Number 5, 결혼하다. 결혼하다 means to marry. Example, 그들은 내년에 결혼할 거예요. 그들은 내년에 결혼할 거예요. 그들 means they. And 은 is topic particle. 내년에 is next year. 결혼할 거예요 means will marry. So, which means they will marry next year. Number 7, 도착하다. 도착하다 means to arrive. Example, 우리는 7시에 도착할 거예요. Here, 우리 is we. 는 is topic particle. 7시 is 7 o'clock and 에 is at. 도착할 거예요 means will arrive like this. So, 우리는 7시에 도착할 거예요 means we will arrive at 7 o'clock. Number 8. 헤어지다. 헤어지다. Which means to break up. Example, 저는 남자친구랑 헤어질 거예요. 저는 남자친구랑 헤어질 거예요. Alright? 저 is, once again, I in a polite way. And 는 is topic particle. 남자친구 is my boyfriend. And 랑 is with. And 헤어질 거예요 means will break up. Here, like this. So, 저는 남자친구랑 헤어질 거예요 means here is my mistake. Which means, I will break up with my boyfriend. Number 9, 끊다. 끊다. Which means to quit. Example, 저는 담배를 끊을 거예요. 저는 담배를 끊을 거예요. Right? 저는 is I, right? And 담배 is kind of noun. 담배 means cigarette. And 담배를 is object particle. 끊을 거예요. 끊을 거예요 means will quit. So 저는 담배를 끊을 거예요 means I will quit smoking. Okay, the last word is 살다. 살다, which means to live. Example, 저는 한국에서 살 거예요. 저는 한국에서 살 거예요. 저 is I, 는 is topic particle, right? And 한국 is Korea, and 에서 is in. 살 거예요 means will live. So, 저는 한국에서 살 거예요 means I will live in Korea. Alright, and thank you for focusing on today's lesson. And here is your homework. Please make your own sentences using today's words. So, please share your sentences like in the Facebook group or at the comment box down below, at YouTube. Either place will be fine. It's up to you. Alright? Then I will see you on Wednesday. Bye-bye!